today I want to show you another little inexpensive trick I did to my X3. So as everybody knows, storage space is a problem in these units. Also, keeping stuff out of the way and hangers and things like that. So, I want to show you how I turned a bag of these for $8.90 or something like that on Amazon.com into nice hangers for my headsets, my goggles and things. You know how it is, you lay your goggles around, they get scratched up no matter what, but if you would pull over, just hang your goggles up there in between, or your helmets, or whatever the case may be, you're in good shape. So I could have done one of two things. I could have pointed those frontwards, but as we all know, if you've ever had a rollover in a unit, everything goes everywhere, and so for safety, I pointed them towards the back, and I could have put two on each and did the hook sideways, but I chose to point them towards the back just for safety in here in rollover. So I'll show you all how I did that next with a couple of quick clips.
Here's how I turn that into that before it's painted and put on. Pretty simple. First thing I did was grab the short end, break off the ball on the end. All this is a little cheap weld, spot weld that they put on it in China, wherever they make them, I'm sure it's China. Put it in my vise, tighten it up just a little bit, didn't take much. And then start heating. So what I'm trying to do is just get the beginning of it hot. It only takes a couple minutes with a simple little torch, you know. And you'll see it turn red in a second. And it makes it real pliable. I would not try to bend these. It takes forever to bend them. And you'll usually crack them or break them if you don't heat them up, just like any metal. So I've got that first bend heated up pretty good. So I'm just going to take some electrical pliers. I'm going to straighten it out. Look how easy that is. Just real simple. All right. Now I'm going to work my way up. Again, I'm going to bend it. I don't have to be perfect yet. Getting straight. Now is about the time I'm going to start heating and bending it with some needle nose. I like these needle nose because they really give you a tight grip on them. Any needle nose will work because this is so soft. This metal becomes so pliable and soft when you do this. So right about now, I'm going to start bending that in the opposite direction. Make a circle. Bend it around. Take the very tip of that thing, get it good and hot. Take that tip in. Just use a mess around here. It's just the way life is anymore for me. Bend her in. Another bend right here. And bend. Play with it a little bit, but you'll get it pretty quick. It looks like the hole isn't big enough yet. There we go. That's not bad. So also, next thing I want to do, when you look at it that way, I'm going to straighten her up in a second. Is now I just need to heat the base of that a little bit. I can grab either set of pliers, and all I want to do is, I don't need heat now, all I want to do is turn that around. Look at it, kind of get her pretty straight. You know what? It's not bad. It's not bad. Test your bolt. Okay, so I need to heat that a little bit and bring her out just a hair more. That bolt and washer is going to hold us in just fine, so you don't have to be perfectly closed per se. It's not like you're going to put a lot of weight on these things, right? I mean, literally, you're going to just be hanging your helmets, goggles and things, because you know how it is with goggles. You just, man, get tired of watching them get scratched up because they get thrown around and ride. Alright, let's manipulate this just a little bit more. So I'm going to bring that out. Make a little bit bigger loop in this one. Not a biggie. Alright, start my bend a little bit quicker. And bend her around. See there? Hopefully this is coming out pretty good. You can see it. Doesn't have to be perfect. Just need to make sure your bolt gets through. And that's just about there. Right now it's still pliable and soft enough for me to play with it. My last one came out a little bit better than this one, but what the heck. So, bolt goes through it just fine. You can see it's a little crooked, messed up. That's where all you do is, it's hot about 2 inches behind it, but it's fine right here. Take it, reshape it a little bit. You know, when I'm looking for perfection, when we're DIYing, I'd like to have seen this one a little bit better, but she's going to work, and she's pretty close to the last one I did. I found my other better one. Took a couple practice runs at it. And so, that's how I make them. I just cool them off in the sink, start it again. That washer, like I said, the nut's covering most of it right now. But that washer is going to cover up anything that's not perfect behind there. So you'll have a good looking ride. Because these, on my ride, they're going facing towards the back because of the poke outs in the front. You know, I don't like anything. If y'all have ever had a rollover, it's violent. Even a minor rollover. Anything poking out in a direction to face you, I think is a bad idea in your unit. I've had buddies split their head open in my unit before for me doing something silly like that too. So. You can play around with it. I've already made mine, so I'm playing around with this one real quickly. But you can see that if you play around with this enough, you'll get it about as good as that one right there. That one turned out really good. And the beauty of it is, for $9, you get 20 of these. So you mess a couple of them up figuring it out. Big deal, right? So hope this helps. Hope it's a great tip for you guys to be able to hang cheap instead of spending 40, 60, $80 on crazy hangers that I think could hurt you in there.